If you use Google Scholar, you're probably familiar with the basic search bar on the homepage. But did you know that there's also an advanced search feature? This advanced search feature can help you to run more precise searches and better find the information you need. To access this feature, go to the upper left-hand corner and click on this icon of three bars. As you can see, this menu contains several features, including the advanced search feature. If you click on this advanced search feature, you'll get this pop-out box, and it will offer you a number of different ways to find articles. The first option is to simply run a search where it will find the articles that have every single word that you type in that search bar. They won't necessarily be in order, they won't necessarily be a phrase, but they'll all be in the search result. The next option is the exact phrase. So there I might type a single phrase, and even though it's multiple words long, it's going to find things where it's that exact phrase in the result. Next up is at least one of the words. This would be where you might be able to place synonyms or similar phrases where you think that maybe one or the other would be good enough. If there are particular words that you know you want to exclude, that goes in the box that says without the words. And then there's the option to select whether you want to look for the words anywhere in the article or only in the title of the article. Finally, you can specify an author, you can specify where it was published, so for example, the journal in which it was published, or you can have a date range. Let's look at how a couple of these work. So let's say I run a search for the phrase performance textiles. You'll see that I'm going to get 926,000 results. So that's a lot of results, and many of these things may not be completely what I'm looking for. So the first few have the phrase performance textiles, but since I said that it was all the words, it won't necessarily be that phrase. This is going to get me anything that has the phrase performance textiles, as well as anything that has both the word performance and textiles in the same article, even if they're not related to each other at all in their usage. So let's go back and take a look at how this number changes when I change how I run the search. So we're going to remember that I have 926,000 results. So if I go back to advanced search, and instead of putting performance textiles here, what if I say I want the exact phrase performance textiles? Running the search again, you'll see that this cuts me down to 1,820 results, and these may well be more accurate for what I want because this is going to be only the exact phrase performance textiles. You do want to be careful. If there are multiple ways that your search term may be referred to, sometimes, for example, as performance textiles, and perhaps sometimes as something with another word in the middle, like maybe there's sometimes where people refer to it as performance wool textiles or something like that. You do want to be careful that those will be excluded if you run an exact phrase search, but it is a way that you can try to narrow your results and more narrowly tailor your results to your needs. Now, going back to the advanced search again, let's say that I wanted to search for two synonyms. I was fine with either of them. So what if I wanted to search blue or cerulean? So if I run that search, you'll see that I'm going to get a large number of results, and that's because it doesn't need to have both of those terms in it. It could have either one or the other, but perhaps not both. And you'll actually see that I typed in the phrase blue or cerulean, but that was unnecessary. So if we look at the search box up here, you'll see that they've added the ors for me. So it's actually searching for the word or as well, which is part of the reason why I got so many results. Now, that means that we're pulling up every single result that has the word or in it. So you do want to make sure that you get rid of that. So let's get rid of that and run the search again, and we'll have far fewer results. So this is now going to have items that only have blue or the word cerulean. Going back to the advanced search once more, maybe you want to run a search where it has the word blue, but you absolutely don't want the word cerulean. So you would type those into those two boxes because now you're going to find only times when they refer to blue without the word cerulean. Now, don't forget, you can also specify that you only want to search in the title of the article if you're looking for a particular article that can be helpful. And you can specify an author, a published journal, which it's in, or a date range if you would like. Using the advanced search features of Google Scholar can make it a very powerful tool in looking for the literature. And don't forget, if you do find something that's not freely available online, you can request it through FIT using interlibrary loan. If you have questions on this or anything else, please ask the library.